Hi, I'm Sandy Graffius, your county controller. It is so nice to be back. I feel like I've been off the air for ages. We had to get off while we were running for office. It's not fair to have a monthly show and run for office at the same time. Thank you, everybody that supported me. I appreciate your support. I'm going to be here another 4 years. My guest tonight is Kellie Butsack, and that is B-U-T-S-A-C-K, Butsack, just like it sounds. I love that. I'm going to say it about five times. Butsack. And she is from Alzheimer's. Now, I have been kidding about this all day because I keep figuring out if I have it or not.
Everybody on the planet asks themselves if they have it or not.
And so they sent me cheat sheets. And I'm sitting here reading my cheat sheet, which are the 10 signs of knowing if you have the Alzheimer's. Oh my gosh, I have everyone.
That's what about everybody says to me when we talk about that, yes.
I just can't decide if, and then it says typical age-related changes. Well, since I'm only 29, that doesn't, you know, even come to me. Now, Kellie, we're going to go back here and tell me what organization you're from.
I am with the Alzheimer's Association, and we are a national organization, but I, being here from the Berks County area, am with the Delaware Valley chapter, which is our local regional chapter that serves this area.
And how big of an area do you serve?
We cover about 7 counties here in southeast Pennsylvania. So Berks is as far west as we go.
Oh.
So we go from Berks County east through Philadelphia. We cover
like Chester and Montgomery.
Yep, we cover all the counties Delaware. Between Berks and Philadelphia. We cover Lehigh and Northampton. We cover Chester, Bucks, Montgomery.
How big is your staff?
We have about, I think, somewhere between 20 and 30 people total on staff.
Do you all have a geographic area that is your domain?
Yes, our chapter.
So you're like Berks.
Well, in my role with the chapter, I actually oversee a lot of activities that go on throughout the entire chapter, but I am based here in Berks County.
Did they make you move here, or did you live
No,
there?
I've always been here.
Okay, good.
I'm a native.
They found me
and they left me stay.
They said, let's suck her right in here.
Yeah,
how long have you been with the organization?
I'm in my 15th year.
Get out. How do you remember that? It's all stars. I'll stop.
It's getting a little rusty.
I'm sorry. I'll stop. I promise I'll stop. Okay. When you have programs, mm-hmm. which I know you do,
yep.
How do you get the word out?
We advertise a lot through our website.
Which is
alz.org.
Oh, that's good. You don't have to spell the whole thing out.
I know. It's just alz.org.
Yeah. Okay.
And anybody here in the local area can plug in their zip code on our homepage, and it will take them to our local chapter website.
Oh, good.
Which gives lists of support groups, lists of local community education programs we're doing. So there's a lot of information on our website.
Let's just not get too far afield here.
Mm-hmm.
How many support groups do you have right here, and who do you serve with it?
In Berks County right now, we have 6 monthly support groups. They're scattered throughout the county.
They meet once a month.
They are free to attend.
And who runs them? Is there somebody that runs them,
yep.
or is it the group all talking to each other?
There is a volunteer support group facilitator.
Okay.
Who actually kind of leads the group.
Yeah, because somebody has to figure out what the topic's going to be.
Somebody
has to keep them on track.
Yep. They provide refreshments, and they bring everybody together.
What do they have to eat?
Usually cookies, coffee, you know, cake.
Oh, yeah, all right.
Kinds of good stuff.
And you said you have 6 here.
We have 6 here scattered around the county. There's one in Wyomissing and Topton and Exeter and spread out throughout the county.
So how many come to these? I'm sure it varies, but do you have like 5 or do you have like 50?
It can vary. It can vary anywhere from 3 to 5 people up to 15, 20 people in any given month. And I think it's free to attend. You don't have to call to sign up or register. People come and go as they need, like other traditional support groups. So 1 month, a group may have 5 people, and the next month, depending on what people are struggling with, they may have 10 people. So it does vary from month to month.
I want to keep saying this, alz.org, so mm-hmm. that they can write this down. Tell me, what are some of the subjects that they cover?
They can talk about anything. It is an open discussion for the caregivers who are coming. So they'll usually do introductions at the beginning of a meeting. They'll go around the room and introduce each other, and then they really open up the floor to what people need to talk about. So somebody may come there in a particular month and they're struggling with a certain issue. They're having trouble getting their loved one to bathe, or they're, you know, whatever the challenge might be. And they can come there and they can get support from the group. They can get advice, suggestions.
Because they're all interacting with the same things. And mm-hmm. so right. anybody that has started to solve it can share that.
Exactly.
I am sure the time commitment that it takes to take care of somebody that you love dearly must be overwhelming.
It is, and it can be.
I'm going to guess yep. that is the biggest bugger.
It is. It is. And finding, being able to, one of the most important services that the association provides for caregivers is to help connect them to resources. Because it is, as time goes on and the disease progresses, it takes more and more time
yeah.
And more effort. So sometimes earlier in the disease, the person is still somewhat independent, but as the disease progresses, they're going to need more
forget,
and more care.
They forget. Mm-hmm. I know that my girlfriend had a mother-in-law who would wander.
Mm-hmm.
Wander. And they just, during the middle of the night.
That can be dangerous.
Yeah, and they can't stay awake all night watching this person.
Exactly.
So what resources do you guys have? And then I'll talk about something we have here in Berks County.
Okay. Yes, we help connect caregivers to resources that they may need at any stage of the disease. So if they're at a point where their loved one needs 24/7 care,
yeah.
Which no one person can provide, we will help connect them to and go through options with them, like maybe using an adult day center, bringing in a home care agency, you know, getting some additional support maybe from a home care agency. If they don't have friends and family that can fill in, they might need to reach out to professional providers.
When you suggest to them daycare or mm-hmm. or home care,
mm-hmm.
are there sliding limits of financial aid, or must they come up with all of it themselves?
Well, financial assistance is a tough issue.
I'll bet.
Not only here, but really around the country.
Oh, I believe that.
You know, there aren't enough programs for financial assistance, and a lot of the programs have waiting lists, and a lot of people, the challenge is that so many families and individuals fall into that gap between
poverty
actually qualifying for yeah. assistance and being able to afford it. You know, there's a lot of people that fall into that gap where they can't really afford it, but they make too much to qualify for assistance.
When
and that's a challenge.
When you do these programs and you talk to them about resources, obviously you have lists you have made up over the years because you know mm-hmm. what facilities are opening and which ones have closed because the people are retiring or whatever. Do they then make an appointment and come in and talk to you about this? How do they get a hold of you?
They can. The best way to get a hold of the association with any type of question or need is really our 24/7 helpline. So we have a toll-free 800 number, which
is... Hang on a minute. If we have the toll-free 800 number, I would appreciate if you could put that up on the screen.
Yeah, I think we have a graphic that shows the website. There it is, the website.
Please get a pencil and paper and write this down.
Yes, that 24/7 helpline number is literally 24/7. And it's not just a crisis line. It is a helpline.
Okay.
So anyone can call that number around the clock.
If you can't see it, it's 1-800-272-3900. Thank you, 3900.
Yeah.
1-800-272-3900. I don't want to give the wrong one. I have been planning contacts, but that's really pretty far away. Please, please, please write that down in case you need it.
Yes, you can call that number any time of the day or night, weekends, holidays, doesn't matter. It's 24/7, 365 days a year. There's care consultants, master's level clinicians who answer that phone number, and they can give people advice. They can walk them through a moment. They can just provide listening if somebody just needs to talk or
come
vent.
Come on back.
And then they can also ask any question. They can get resource information. They can call and say, I need a support group. And that's very helpful for people who maybe don't have a computer and they can't look up things online
that's
on
correct.
Our website.
That's correct.
They can just call the number and we can
Where does your funding
answer any
come
question.
From? Do you have any idea?
Private funding.
No kidding.
Mm-hmm. Private
Donations.
Funding. Donations. Yep.
How big is your mailing list?
Don't receive any funding. It's big.
and is
it's big. There's 5.8 million people in this country diagnosed, so we have a big list.
And you get all your funding. What did you say? You did 25 people on your staff. Is that what you said?
Yeah.
And you get all your funding for 25 people through private donations.
Mm-hmm. Wow, we do. We get private donations. Of course, we have events like our walk events. We have fundraising events like most
Let's
nonprofits.
Let's talk about that.
Well, we had walk season is over, unfortunately, at this time of the year. However, all of our physical walks have already taken place, but we do accept donations for our walk campaign through the end of the year. So anybody can still donate. Our walk here in Berks County was on October 6th, and it was at Penn State Berks. It's usually the first Saturday in October.
And then will you do walk around the campus?
So, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And do people pay a certain amount for how far you walk?
No. Well, yes, they can. Yes, if I thought you meant do they pay to come. No.
No, no.
There's no registration fee, but all the walkers donate. They ask people to donate to them. So whether they ask, people have the option of making a flat donation, or if they want to sponsor somebody for how far they walk, they can do that too. However they want to contribute.
One time I did a fundraiser for Junior Achievement. It was a bowl-a-thon.
Mm-hmm.
And I broke my ankle.
Oh.
I was there in my wheelchair, and they stood me up at the line and hung onto my waistband, and I leaned over.
They should have let you use the bumpers.
Well, I've got to tell you, I can't bowl to begin with, but that was the best excuse I ever had. And funny, I just turned around to everybody and I said, just give me money. Don't pay me
That's
for
right.
the pins that are going down, because I'm dead in the water.
That's what most people do today. I know. You know, when I started in the nonprofit world 20, 30 years ago, that was really how we raised money for any type of walkathon.
Yeah.
It was so much per mile. People would pledge. But we've come to the point today where most people just make a flat donation to someone.
And how much do you raise with that?
In Berks County, we raise, I think our goal for this year is $190,000.
Are you kidding?
Mm-hmm. And I think we're about 80% to goal right now. So
$190,000 on a walkathon?
Mm-hmm.
I shouldn't say it too loudly. The other organizations are all going to call you.
Now, our chapter also has a walk in Philadelphia because
okay.
we cover Philadelphia. Our Philadelphia walk is actually the largest walk in the country. We raise over, I think, $1.5 million.
Oh, that blows my mind.
At our Philadelphia walk.
Oh, that blows my mind.
That's our primary fundraiser for the year. We don't do a lot of fundraisers in general through the association. We're not out there doing fundraisers every month. Our walk is really our
bread
and butter.
But you said $190,000 in Berks.
Just here in Berks County.
Oh, my gosh, that's amazing.
We have a lot of, we're very blessed and fortunate to just have a lot of dedicated walkers and donors and volunteers that really
do
make that happen.
Do you get a lot of corporate
We do.
Sponsorship?
We do. Yep. Yep. Not to discount our corporate partners.
Do they sponsor teams that
mm-hmm.
work there?
Yep.
And who?
Yeah, a lot of the, for example, a lot of the residential living communities in the area have teams.
No kidding.
Yeah. Like Genesis, Chestnut Knoll, a lot of the day centers, a lot of the home care agencies have teams. Because they're serving the same
clients that we're serving.
Yeah, so a lot of the businesses and corporate partners have teams as well.
Well, I wanted to tell you, I'm so thrilled with this. When I was reading over my good stuff today, which is this online by any chance?
It is, yep.
Okay, online are Know the 10 Signs of Alzheimer's, of which I have 9. No, I'm only kidding. It tells you what the sign is, and then it also tells you the typically age-related changes. So if you are concerned about whether or not you stepped over the line, go on alz.org. How do you like
exactly.
that? How do you like that?
Got to keep it simple.
And
look,
what?
The graphic is up there, the 10 warning signs.
And I'm telling you, this is so fun, but read it with a cup of coffee first thing in the morning so that you're bright-eyed and bushy-tailed.
There you go.
Yeah, because it talks about, like, not remembering people's names, which I haven't done that since I'm 22. Now, as I was reading over this stuff, I remembered that our sheriff's department, Berks County Sheriff's Department, has a program, and you said you guys also have one too.
Mm-hmm.
What this is it looks like an Apple Watch, and it has, I don't know if you can see this or not. Can you zero in on this at all? Yeah, that's good. Do whatever you can. It's like a watch, and it goes on the person's wrist, and it is numbered, and then it's monitored. And if the person gets out of the house or gets lost and is unfindable at the moment for the family, you can make a call to our sheriff's department, and they will monitor. I act like I have one on, but this is an Apple Watch. This is in case my kids can't find me. No, I'm only kidding. But it's a wristband, and they wear it, and they can monitor it. It usually takes no more than 30 minutes to be able to spot with this GPS because it's on the person's arm.
Mm-hmm.
If in fact you're interested, I want you to call the sheriff's department, and there is a person named Captain Tim Moore who is in charge of this. And up on the screen is the number. It's 610-478-6240, extension 3214.
And that is Project Lifesaver.
Mm-hmm. Now, what happens is there is a fee. I need you to know there's going to be a fee. But if you're worried about your loved one going out of the house during the middle of the night or going to the store and forgetting how to get back home again, if they have on this monitoring device, then they can be tracked through a computer program. So if, in fact, you didn't get the information down fast enough, if you go on our county website, which is www.countyofberks.com, countyofberks.com. There's going across the top, it shows all the different departments. If you click on the departments, you'll come to the sheriff's department. And then when you come to the sheriff's department, you can scroll down through and you can find out about this Project Lifesaver, which is a public safety program. They're using it for autistic youngsters. They're using it for senior citizens. They're using it for anybody that might get lost and not be able to find their way back home. Now, you said you also had a program that you folks used, didn't you?
Well, the association, we use a wandering program that is administered through Medic Alert. So, okay. You know, the Medic Alert bracelets that people wear if they have epilepsy or diabetes or
can that be computerized? Huh?
Yeah, well, it's not computerized. If they wear the jewelry, and then there is if someone goes missing, there is a protocol search and rescue process that happens through Medic Alert.
Okay.
So,
I'll tell you.
So that's another option as well.
There's some of this technical stuff out there that if you're really struggling, it'll help you. But if you want to call, just use the Berks County program. You call the sheriff's department and ask to talk to Captain Moore. Let's see if I know his first name. Tim. Do I know his first name? Yes, I do. Okay, so we have $190,000 coming in. That can't be your whole budget for 25 people.
No, we do. We get some grant funding for different programs that we do. I think we get some support in different areas through some of the United Ways, in different counties and regions.
Do you have the ability to help place people in facilities?
Well, we don't. We don't provide direct care, and we don't directly help place people in services.
So you're an information agency,
right.
And
education, information, resources. So we can help people find resources that help
which
them.
They,
we help them with care
which
planning,
they which they wouldn't know.
Right.
Now, when you help them with care planning, when do you get? I know this is varied. When do you get to the end of the line, you say, I just can't do this anymore. We need to have 24-hour care, and they need to go into an Alzheimer's unit somewhere.
And that is an option. There are some families that do have the resources and are able to keep their loved ones home throughout the journey.
Just by doing 7/24.
Yeah, or bringing in care from outside or hiring a home care agency. But most individuals do have to be placed in facility care.
Yes.
And we help them look at the different options in their area. We help them, again, if they need resources or assistance, we talk to them about, do they qualify for veterans benefits? What about the county waiver program? Yeah, so we help them sort through the options, of how to how to make that happen. And I know, a lot of good.
I know from being controller that Berksheim is one of the bigger Alzheimer units in the county. And of course, we're fighting for funding all the time for Berksheim because we want to keep that facility open. What else is available besides Berksheim?
I think we have about half a dozen communities in the county that have memory care units.
Is that what it's called? Memory care?
Yeah, memory care units. Yeah. Like the Heim does. The Heim has their memory care unit, which is wonderful. I hear good things from families who are there.
We're really
they have a waiting list right now. But
yeah, we're focused on that.
Yeah, so they have a good program at the Heim. And I think we have good programs, a lot of good programs in this county.
And what's it called, memory?
A memory care unit.
I used to have an outlet store, and our sizes ran up to about 6X. And we used to call them Pretty Plus, and that's like the memory care unit. You try to find a nurturing name for something that's really tough.
Yeah,
is it more prevalent for men than women?
Statistically speaking, actually, there's more women who are diagnosed, and you know there are. We're still studying why there's more women diagnosed. There could be a lot of reasons for that.
Only maybe because women live longer.
Yes, and women outnumber men. There are just more women in this country than there are men. So we outnumber men. We tend to live longer. So there's a lot of reasons that
we have exactly 2 minutes left. What didn't I ask you?
The holidays. I did want to just mention. I know we're coming into the holiday season, and that's a really tough time for caregivers. And a lot of times caregivers struggle with how to include their loved ones in holiday activities.
Okay.
Again, you can visit our website for tips.
ALZ.org.
But to think about caregivers for people with Alzheimer's and dementia do have to kind of prepare for the holidays, you know, and the holiday activities can be overwhelming for someone with dementia. There's a lot of noise and people and activity, and it can be overwhelming. So things to think about, like if you're going to include your loved one with dementia, is there a safe space for them to escape?
Oh, that's interesting.
From the overwhelmingness in the home.
Oh, that's interesting.
To prepare those kind of things. And we even have a gift-giving guide and different tips for the holiday season.
And that's all on the website, alz.org. Yeah. I love that.
You got it.
I'm telling you, I love it. You had to make it easy for me because you saw out there in the lobby how I spelled Alzheimer's. And I cut it.
But you have a system. So.
I've got to tell you, it wasn't even close. I can't tell you what a pleasure it was having you here. Please, please, please call the county if you're interested in that program for tracking persons when they get lost. And please contact these folks because they do have resources that are available. And instead of you trying to talk to everybody in the community, see where they are, even if you don't do anything besides join a support group, you have to be able to get relief somewhere.
There is help. You just have to know how to find it.
I can't imagine. Mm-hmm. It's just overwhelming. I say to my daughter, you know, no matter what happens, I don't want to get Alzheimer's. I don't want to get dementia. I'm going to feel horrible. She's like, you won't know it. What do you care, Mom? You won't know
that's
it.
That's true. That could be true.
Well, that's a big fat help. Thanks a lot. So you are now doing Berks County. You have 4 or 5 counties that you're working in from here down to Philadelphia because you're regional. Mm-hmm. And when you get around next year to October, if you want to go on the walkathon at Penn State, for crying out loud, go on alz.org and sign up. Now, do you have the ability to put people in coaches and push the coaches around and put the leashes on the dogs and take the dogs around?
We do. It's very doggy friendly. We have a lot of dogs that join us at the walk in Penn State.
And I think what we should have is a wheelchair so that you can push me around. You want to push me around? Go ahead.
We can arrange that.
Thank you so much for being here, Kellie.
Thanks for having me, Sandy.
It was terrific.
Thank you. Happy holidays.
Thank you.